She just told me a concert, but I didn't know it was a donor and diabetes and cancer benefit concert. But I too am a survivor of cancer. Listen. But y'all know me, I'm gonna have to talk just a little bit, but I wanna speak life. We talk about a lot about this day, Easter Day. Help me out just a little bit, girl, just a little bit. We talk about this day a whole lot without understanding it. That's why all the rest of the year, we don't really talk about the cross that much, because Easter is that day. He died for our sins, but we don't really understand the fulfillment of who we are because of the cross, our identity. So I ask a lot of people, you know, if you were redeemed from something, or redeemed to something, what would you once be as? We don't understand the cross. We don't understand. We say, I'm saved. I accepted Jesus. I am the redeemed, but you are the redeemed. But what does that mean? By faith, you are what? What were you once deemed for? Tell somebody, I was once deemed as an eternal being. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Y'all mean, I know my voice. Say, I was once redeemed. I was once deemed as an eternal being. So when you're redeemed, you understand the fall of man, Adam and Eve, when they fell, we fell from heavenly places. We fell from eternal. You understand what I'm saying? But through Jesus Christ, through the cross, we were redeemed back to eternal things. So I'm listening to the testimony tonight, and y'all not understanding. Y'all saying, oh, hallelujah, they was healed. But you don't understand. Only healing can take place because of the redeemed, because of what Jesus did. Yeah. Listen, cancer don't reside in heaven. Diabetes don't reside in heaven. So when see, I get upset because we diminish the cross because we only say he died for my sins. No, but he conquered the sin. See, y'all don't understand. God was so confident in his son Jesus Christ that when he let him down on the cross, he ain't worried about your sin, he ain't worried about your homosexuality, he ain't worried about your blood. He's worried about you understanding who you are eternally. See, if we ever get an understanding of who we are by way of the cross, we ain't got to worry about our struggles because we understand who I was before the foundation of the world is who I am now again because of Jesus. I am redeemed. So when the Bible says when we accept Christ, we serve our parents, we have eternal life. Eternal life is not when you die. It's now. I wish I would get it. I'm trying. Eternal life is now, not when you die. You are eternal being now. See, before Adam and Eve fell, there was a place called Eden. Eden was a place like heaven. I'm trying to understand this day. This day ain't just happening for your sin. Him conquering sin was a result of the redemption plan. The redemption plan was in place. Go read, please. I challenge you. Go home and read Ephesians, the first chapter and the second chapter. The redemption plan was put in place before you ever fell, for Adam ever fell. So when Jesus came, he redeemed you back to an eternal position. Sin didn't reside. So when Jesus came, your sin was taken away, but he redeemed you back to a place where cancer don't reside. Diabetes don't reside. By faith, we always say, I'm saved. What are you saved to? What is salvation? It's faith. What is the prerequisite of salvation? Faith. What am I putting faith in? He died, he is the Son of God. No, you're putting the faith in the fact that when he died, your cancer, come on, he says, by my stripes I am healed. I'm wounded. That's what we're putting faith in. We're putting faith in the works of what Jesus did. Guess what? Muslims believe in Jesus. All other religions believe in Jesus. But they don't believe that he was the Messiah. Not only that, they don't believe that when he died, the finished work was unto us. So they don't believe that when he died, what he did was now transferred to us. Look, as a matter of fact, when you fall because you're identified with Christ, God don't see your fall. He see his blood. See, y'all see, we shout on the wrong stuff, but we still shout on the, he ain't killed because of my sin. No, he not going to kill you because his blood covered it. This on Easter, these days, we diminished it to shouting and dancing because he died. I mean, we don't understand. We're praising from a guilty position. You don't understand? See, you're worried about somebody smoking a cigarette, but when you, the Bible says, any man that lacks faith is in sin. When you operate from a guilty perspective after being a believer, It wasn't about homosexuality. It wasn't about cigarettes and smoking. It wasn't none of that stuff there. What happened was the emotions of man came in, which was guilt, shame, need for belonging. Those are the roots. See, we've been preaching for years at the stuff that we see, not understanding the root. See, I'm trying to get this Easter message. This is an Easter message. The problem is we've been preaching at the stuff that we struggle with, not understanding that it was the root. Cigarettes ain't a sin. I'm so contrary. A cigarette ain't a sin. The moment you make a cigarette in place of God, anybody that lacks faith is in what? In sin. The moment I reject God as my Savior and turn to the cigarette as my coping mechanism, that's the sin. So as believers, we shouting, I ain't do this tonight, I ain't do that last night, but you got a guilty conscience, you're in sin. What did he say? The moment we feel necessary, that guilt is what we need to repent. In the moment we just move, conviction. Conviction never feels like guilt. Conviction always feels like love. Are y'all hearing me tonight? I feel like we need to hear this. Because we shout and dance about Easter and Jesus. He got up and did what? What happened? Life after the third day. What happened? I'm saying now what? We don't know our identity in Christ. So tonight as we sing stuff like, so now rest in me, now rest. I want y'all to understand, we ain't saying rest Jesus. No, we don't need no rest. He did the work. What he's saying is you chill, you rest, you take a break. Because I'm finished it. I'm getting it. He said, I finished it.